for them, right? We have a word from the Lord.
Well, I wouldn't take nothing from my journey now.
Thank you. up in the air just to know that one day I'm going to get to stand there and watch my King be crowned.
That's right.
The King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. And I can't wait, Terry, to get there. I can't. Oh, man, I'm dead. But I can sit here and hold my hands up and say I'm glad to be asleep.
That's right.
I lost my leg, but I did not lose my faith in Christ.
That's right.
I am here today because I am a saved man.
Yes.
At 8 years old in a little town called Rockford, Illinois, I got on my knees and made him my Savior. I ain't always lived it, but I can tell you right now, I live it today. There's times that I can't be here because of this, but you know what? I'm here.
Amen.
And if we could sing that song just one more time. Because it is. I want to tell you this. I can't wait till I'm looking my Savior in the eyes. Because when I walk through those pearly gates, before I even walk through those pearly gates, Jody, I'm going to have a new body.
Amen.
Wait to my Savior and get on my knees and thank Him for everything that He's done for me.
That's right.
Amen. Let's do it again.
Oh, when at last I see my risen Savior, it's before His image of the love's ripley. Oh, and when they crown Him King of Kings, I'll be there. For you see, this is just
comfort, my shelter, tower. on Wednesday night, Pastor Jody preached on baggage. Very, very, very good sermon. And that's actually one thing that we concentrate on when we go to our ladies' retreats is the baggage that we tend to hold on to, that we carry with us no matter where we go, whether it's home or work or church. But he put it in a little bit of a different light that I guess I hadn't considered. But that baggage, you know, as long as you're holding on to it and you've got it all in your hands and you never give it to the Lord, or maybe you give it to him, but then when you get up from praying, you pick it back up and you take it back with you again. How can he give you anything new? How can he further you along in your walk with him? And it's that baggage that prevents us from living out the fullness that the Lord has for us. And to think of, you know, where would I have been had I not carried or held on to all of that baggage? Our baggage is pride, bitterness, anger, resentment, unforgiveness. Things that hold us back from being all that God made us to be, all that he wants us to be. I don't know about you, but I want everything that the Lord has for me, because he wants so much better for myself than I even can even imagine. Because his ways are perfect. And he is with us through everything. He is with us through it all. This morning, but I want to make sure that I'm not holding on to any more baggage, because I had to repent after that message. It's like, God, I've got to lay this all that down. I can't let stuff hold me back. Stuff that doesn't matter. I want to become the woman of God that he has destined me to be, so that I can reach people for Christ. Where I'm supposed to be, I would not be able to minister to them. He wants to promote you within the kingdom of God. So we are all on different spiritual levels. And we need to be able to continually pull and encourage each other and support each other, especially when those storms of life come through that kind of blindside you. And we can't be ready if we're holding on to our baggage.
I've had many tears and sorrows. I've had questions for tomorrow. And there's been times I didn't know right from wrong. To depend upon
thank you, Jesus. Come on, church, one time. Ourselves in trouble just leaning on what we think by the carnal mind. How many knows you can't serve God with a carnal mind? You got to serve Him with spirit. Amen. Lori, go to the piano. I don't know if Sherry does the same. This song keeps just rolling over. Just stay on that B flat. We'll go to B flat. This is a Southern gospel song. If you don't like Southern gospel, don't go to heaven because it's where it started. I can show it to you in scripture. Empty and broken, I came back to Him. The vessel so unworthy, I was so scarred by sin, but He did not despair. He started over again. Me.
Oh, but then she
The streams whereof make glad the city of God, the Bible says. And on each side of the river there is a tree of life planted that bears its manner of fruit monthly, the Bible says. No way to get from this side of the river to that side of the river. Except that when Ezekiel saw that river and said, no way to get over it. But when you come to the book of Revelation, the revelation of who Jesus Christ is, he said, I saw that same river that Ezekiel saw, and on this side of the river there was a tree of life planted, and on that side of the river there was a tree of life planted, but no way to get across until I saw the man come down and dig in the center of that river and planted a tree of life, but not only on this side, not only on that side, but now in the midst of the river there is a tree of life. How do I get from this side to that side? I'm glad to report to you this morning that the mercy of God is renewed morning by morning. When you got up this morning, it does not matter what you did yesterday. It don't matter all the sin you might have committed yesteryears or even yesterday. When you got up this morning, when the sun come up, I came to that fountain, drank of that water. I've never been thirsty since then. Hallelujah. Somebody said, you ought to turn around and go back to that world. I ain't got nothing to go back to. I believe I'm just going to hang on to what Jesus gave me. I heard the Bible say, he that endures unto the end, the same shall be saved. I want to be saved when it comes to the end. So I think I'm just going to hold on just a little bit. I've got more to go to heaven for today than I've ever. How can that person repent? How can that person shout? I know stuff about them. You may know stuff about them, but what you don't know is how big our God is. Hallelujah. There ain't no big sin, no sin, big or too big that God can't wipe the slate clean. You ain't made enough mistakes. You ain't went too far, and his arm can't reach down and save you. His ear, hallelujah, can hear what you cry. I came by to tell you, if that was true, if you could wander outside the grace of God, can I shout to you and tell you the prodigal son would have never felt that longing to come home, but it was after he took that Yeah, I might as well go. Boy, I feel the Lord all over me. You can't just turn over a new leaf. You can't just make it better for yourself. You can't just decide to go to church and think you're going to heaven. You got to be born again. Hallelujah. Not by water only, but by water and blood. Nicodemus, think it not strange that I said unto thee, you must be born again. For that which is born of flesh is flesh, but that which is born of spirit is spirit. There is a void down in the heart of every human being that's been born of a woman. And that void longs to say, I need a God to fill that void. I'm telling you, if you get born again, there'll be the Holy Ghost move inside of you. There'll be the spirit of regeneration that'll come inside of you and make you a new creature in Christ Jesus. All things will pass away, and behold, all things will be new. I don't even know if I can sing it.
I've ever done. You know, in this city, I've been a sinner woman. You know,
Lord's name. Just sit where you're at. No sense in going to find Jesus. What will your friends say? Maybe they're looking for the same thing you're looking for. Maybe it takes you finding it first. Don't you want to go to heaven? Don't you want a life change? I'm going to tell you something, I'm going to be real brave. You wouldn't be in this church this morning if you were satisfied with the life you're living. Hello, somebody. I went to church that Easter Sunday morning because I wanted a change in my life. He gave it. He'll give it to you. God's good, ain't he?
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Thank you for coming this morning. We'll be back tonight at 6 o'clock and have church. I want you to come and be a part of that. How many of y'all were here two Wednesday nights ago when I taught on the music God listens to? Anybody else in there? The music God listens to. I taught about David playing the harp and Warren with his hands. And I told our musicians that Wednesday night, every time you get up and play a note, do what David did. He got so anointed playing the harp that the Bible said he drove evil spirits out of Saul's heart. And when you get up to play a musical instrument or you sing a song, if you sing it in the right anointing, the right attitude, can I get an amen? Not only does it free you, it'll free people that's listening to you. The Bible says that David said, the Lord's taught me to war with my hands. He wasn't talking about a physical fight. He was talking about warring in the spirit while he was playing that harp. And so anyway, that's why we need services, good anointed singing. We don't always have to have preaching every service. And I believe when the Holy Ghost takes over, he can just have his way. Amen. And the Lord will get involved in all of our music if we just allow him to do that. You love the Lord?
Amen.
Good. Chastity, when you do, honey? 2 weeks. We'll have us a baby. And we'll have us a new member of the church. Gonna be a girl? No girl. All right. She will look like Chess. The good always outweighs the bad. Hallelujah. I think they'll make a good looking baby, don't you?
Amen.
Yeah. Let's do our offering right quick before we leave. Y'all see this guy walking up front here, this old man? He had a birthday this past week, Mr. Bollinger. But he looks good for 68. Oh, I'm kidding. How old are you, Randy?
55.
55.
Double
dick. 55 and alive.
55
to 11. All right, let's do our offering. Hallelujah.
Is that work
though?
Think they're
going to
have my leg
up in
that
way? No. Risk your body stealing love.
I'm
sung out. Bobby, they're trying to take up an offering. We're having revival. Let me announce that while we're doing that. We're having revival the last week of March. And the last week of March. March the 31st.
John.
Of 1989. Is that right, Tony? 1989, yeah. It's when we started Redemption Harvest, me and Brother Tony, Sister Kathy, and three others. And so we're having revival to mark that 28-year celebration. Sunday night we're going to start and go through Friday night. Sunday night will be Brother Mike Hahn. Monday night will be Brother Todd Hicks. Tuesday night's going to be Brother Eddie Myers. Wednesday night's going to be Brother Harry Isaacs. Thursday will be George Roberts. And Friday we're going to end with Brother David Snyder. And so they're coming. And they're going to be preaching every night with different preachers. And I want you to plan on being there. Go ahead. When you get home today, before you cook, before you do anything, mark your calendar. Don't do nothing this week but go to revival. All right? And so we'll be in revival that week. And I'm so strict about that. I told Chastity, if you wait around to have that baby in revival, I'm going to be plumb upset. So she's got to have that baby within 2 weeks. So anyway, March the 26th through the 31st. If you'd like to have a flyer, I've done it somewhere. Here, trumpet man. Take this back there, that back thing. And save me about 12 of those out of there. Count me up 12 of them. And if you'd like to have a flyer, now don't take it home and throw it on your cabinet because you don't know we're having a revival. If you want to take them somewhere and put them up, they'll let you put them up and announce revival. Or if you've got a church that you want to mail them to, that would be great. Invite them. We're going to invite a bunch of churches around us. And we're crossing denominational lines. We've got Church of God guys preaching here just to satisfy Sharon. And no, I'm kidding about that. I'm kidding. We've got Church of God guys preaching. We've got holiness guys preaching. We've got some Baptist guys preaching. And I'm looking forward to all of it. Because how many knows all of us have got something to say to the body of Christ? I was at work the other day and shared with a preacher. This preacher came in. I shared with him the revival we're having. When I mentioned names, he said, "Why would you do that?" And some of those guys, Baptist guys, and you know what my reply was? I said, "Yes, they are. Half of your congregation got saved because of going to a Baptist church." I said, "You didn't win them people. The Baptist preacher wins them. And then us Pentecostals get them sanctified." The best soul winners in the world is Baptist preachers. Amen. I believe that. And they have something to say to the body of Christ. And one guy said, "Why would you have Church of God guys coming in? You're not Church of God." I think they got something to say to the body of Christ. And I don't think a true, true God-given revival can happen until the church tears down walls and becomes the body of Christ together. Love you. God bless you. Don't forget tonight at 6 o'clock, see you here. And I'll, if the Lord will, and I'll preach tonight. How about that? Good night, or good day. God bless you. See you tonight.